Part 2 of the winter party dress making up. Now for the skirt. This is the front with the fold. This is the back with the zip opening. At this stage, we will add the pocket bags. They are positioned here. To add a bit of body at the pocket opening, we will add a strip of iron-on interfacing here and on the backs to strengthen these corners. Then we will prepare the front pleats, bringing the dots together. You could have the pleats facing away from the centre for a different look. If you are happy with the way the pleats fall, temporarily tack them in position. Make sure the edges are lined up across the top. Then double machine along here to hold them in place. I have sewn the pocket bags to the pocket extensions. Next, we join the skirt side seams. We will leave the back seam open until the zip is inserted. Line up the side seams and pockets and stitch from the waist around the pocket bags, making sure you pass through the dots and down to the hemline. The side seams are stitched. Before we can press these seams open, we need to snip towards the dots. We can then press open the side seams below and above the pocket. The pocket bag can then be pressed towards the front. Press from the wrong side. So now we have our pocket finished. Next, we will be joining the bodice and skirt together. To match up the bodice with the skirt, match the side seams and the pleats to the dots. The back skirt needs to be gathered between the notches. You can either run two rows of machine gathering or a double thread running stitch by hand. I like the different treatment of the fullness between the front and the back skirt. This is a good time to try on your garment and make any adjustments. It is easy at this stage to take in a little at the side seams if there is too much ease. The bodice is now joined to the skirt. The dress is looking very pretty. I have trimmed the seam allowance and pressed the seam allowance towards the bodice. Be careful not to press the gathers or the pleats. You want them to remain as soft folds. I have machine basted the back seam just for trying on. Now for the lining. If you are a complete beginner, see the links below. I am assuming you know the basics, such as how to stitch darts, pressing seams, understitching, etc. We will now join the facing to the lining. Right sides together. These are opposing curves which are difficult to sew together. Clip the seam allowance all the way along. This makes it easy to match the two stitching lines. Be sure to match and pin the notches together before you snip the curves. The same goes for the back and with the raglan sleeve sections. This sits over the shoulder. I have now joined all the facings to the lining pieces. I've trimmed and pressed the seam allowance down. We assemble the lining in the same way as the main fabric. Join the raglan sleeve seams and then the underarm seam and the side seams. Then we will add the skirt lining. The lining is complete. I've added the skirt. The skirt lining is not as full as the dress. The fullness is in the form of small pleats at the waistline, front and back. We are going to add a concealed zip in the back seam. It should be beige. My stock of zips is running low, so I'm using what I have. It's a concealed zip, so it should be okay. So the zip is in place and it doesn't show. Check the link below for my double quick, double easy method for inserting an invisible zip. I might just change the pink zip pull though. The next job is to finish the centre back seam below the waist. Again, check the link, sewing a pencil skirt, for my easy zip method. Now for the collar. I have added the soft padding. It is just catch stitched in place. Yes, this is what I am looking for, a soft padded, unstructured look at the neckline. So fold right sides together and stitch the ends. It will be trimmed, the corners mitered and then turned through. The collar will be sandwiched between the main garment and the facing. Here is the collar turned through. I have machine basted along here to keep the edges together. Match to the neckline on the main garment. Snip into the neckline curve to help you. Turn the seam allowance in at the centre back, pin and baste in position, then match the facing, pin and baste. The collar is sandwiched between the layers. This is now machined. Make sure you stitch from the garment side, not the facing side, so that you can be sure you are following the true neckline. Trim and grade the seam allowance. So turning the lining to the inside, we can see how it looks. After trimming, press the seam towards the facing and understitch by stitching the seam allowance to the facing to keep the seam in place. So when that is done, we can turn through and finish the back opening. I've already turned back the zip tape. I've left the facing seam allowance so that when this is turned back, the seam allowance can be turned in. It is quite bulky, but once it is pressed, it will be fine. So that will give us a neat finish at the centre back. So the neckline seam is pressed and understitched. Don't worry if you have a few creases here on the inside. It's the front that's important. Before we go any further, we will finish the centre back seam of the lining up to the point where the zip ends. So going back to the neckline, we will be turning in and pinning the facing and lining to the zip tape, ready for slip stitching in place. To finish, we will sew on a hook and hand worked loop in these two places as a closure. This sew along continues in part 3. See the link below. You will find sew alongs and ebooks for many of my patterns. All are free on my site and on YouTube. You will find my range of classic sewing patterns at angelacaine.com/sewing patterns. Subscribe to my channel to stay up to date. Thank you for watching this video.